Hi children, today we are going to learn about measuring capacity. See here children, it is a spoon. Spoon can contain only small amount of milk. In the same way, it is a teacup. This can also contain small amount of tea. So, the object which contain small amount is called the least capacity object. The object which can hold small amount of things are called the least capacity object. In the same way, this is a water bottle. This can contain more amount of water. Similarly, this is a bucket, and the bucket also can contain more amount of water. So, the object which can contain more things are called greatest capacity object. Least capacity objects can be measured in milliliter. It can be represented as ml. See children, the least capacity object can be measured in milliliters. It is represented as ml. In the same way, the greatest capacity object can be measured in liter. It is represented as L. The greatest capacity object can be measured in liter. It is represented as L. Now we are going to see about conversion of capacity. Here 1000 milliliter equals 1 liter. See children, 1000 milliliter is always equal to 1 liter. We want to convert the liter to milliliter means we have to multiply the value with 1000. In the same way, if you want to convert milliliters to liters means we have to divide by 1000. If we want to convert from milliliters to liters means we have to divide by 1000. See children, if you want to convert liters to milliliters means multiply by 1000, and if you want to convert milliliters to liters means divide by 1000. For example, the jug can contain 3 liters 250 milliliters of water. How many milliliters can the jug contain? Here we have to convert liters to milliliters. We have to convert liters to milliliters. So if you want to convert liters to milliliters means we have to multiply the value with 1000. See children, 1 liter equals 1000 milliliters. So we are multiplying by 1000. In question they have given 3 liters 250 milliliters. That we can separate and write 3 liters plus 250 milliliters. Now we have to convert liters to milliliters. So we are multiplying 3 into 1000. 3 into 1000 milliliters plus 250 milliliters. That we don't need to change because it is already in milliliter. So 3 into 1000 milliliter is 3000 milliliters. 3000 milliliter plus 250 milliliters. See, the units are same. In 3000 also we have milliliter. 250 also we have milliliters. So if we have same units means we can add. So 3000 plus 250 is 3250 milliliters. So if we convert 3 liters and 250 milliliters into milliliters means the answer is 3250 milliliters. Convert 4000 milliliters into liters. See here children, now we have to convert milliliters to liters. If we want to convert milliliters to liters means we have to divide by 1000. See, 1000 milliliter equals 1 liter. 1000 milliliter equals 1 liter. So we have to divide by 1000. In question they have given 4000 milliliters. question they have given 4000 milliliters. So this 4000 milliliter we can write it as 4000 divided by 1000 liters. Because we have to convert this milliliters to liters, no? So we are dividing by 1000. Now 4000 divided by 1000, the answer is 4 liters. So if we convert 4000 milliliters into liter means the answer is 4 liters. The same way convert 5563 milliliters into liters. See here children, here also we have to convert milliliters to liters. If you want to convert milliliters to liters means we have to divide by 1000. We have to divide by 1000. 1000 milliliter equals 1 liter. So only we are dividing by 1000. In question they have given 5563 milliliters. That we can separate and write 5000 milliliters plus 563 milliliters. Now we want to convert this milliliters to liters. So we want to divide 5000 divided by 1000 liters. 5000 divided by 1000 plus 563 milliliters. 5000 divided by 1000 is 5 liters. 5 liter plus 563 milliliters. See here the units are different. Here 5 is in liter, 563 is in milliliter. So we cannot add these two. So we are writing as it is. If we convert 5563 milliliters to liters means the answer is 5 liter 563 milliliters. Thank you.